Right then. Today, rear brake discs and pads and calipers and basically everything. It's all knackered. They were that worn out that one of the pads fell out at Sporridge's. And the MOT is next week, so thought I'd best do them. We have the jack in place. Bit overkill, but despite what they say, size definitely does matter. Yeah, I'll set you up. Get the wheel off, and then we'll have a look.
God. I don't know why they put these stupid little cap things on.
Oh. I've learnt the hard way not to do that.
Turn a 20-minute job into a several-day job. Getting that bit wrong. I don't know if you can hear those cows next door, but I don't think they're very happy. I'm going to write a letter of complaint. I'm not one of those people. Oh wow. There. Listen up. Get a bigger hammer. Safety first. Right.
So, brake disc, brake caliper. Caliper carrier. I don't know what that does. It's just sort of a guard, really, in the back. So what we need to do is undo that one and that one. I'll turn some lights on in here, see if we can get a bit better light. But yes, I'll put you somewhere and then have a look. See if we can see that.
Can you see me? Can you see? All the way in the way. No, you can see that. Right, so it's 212 mils, I think. Depending on how much rust is on them. Righty tighty. Yeah. Oh, thank God. Oh, they both undid. Look at that. Marvellous. That is a rarity. These normally rusted in so hard that they either don't undo or they just snap. So that's that undone. Now we can get the caliper off, or try. There we go. Caliper off. You can see him. This side might be fine, but they're so cheap that I thought I'd just get two new ones anyway. Oh wow! Bring you out of there a minute.
Probably managed worth out of that, didn't I? The other side was even worse because that fell out. And that one's not so bad. But if they're they're worn so uneven like that, these are supposed to move in and out. They're probably seized in there like the other side. Well, they're only, what's that, 19 quid each, I think it was, and then the calipers, 26 quid. And yeah, so I thought, well, if one side's gone, the other side's gonna have gone as well. This isn't grinding yet, well, the back is a bit, but nothing major. Right, I shall set you up again because now I need to undo that one and that one. The light is really bad. I do apologise. Right, that one there and that one there. Are they 13s? Yes, they are. How rare is that to pick up the right socket when you need it? No, this way. Oh, that undid as well. Oh, marvellous. I do like undoing stuff that's been put together by mechanics before. These would have been put on by the bloke that I bought this from. Who is actually a mechanic? Fred Sanders servicing, or something like that. Just outside Barnstable. Fred Sanders diesel specialist. That's what it is. Oh god. There's one. And there is that one. So that is that off. These, I'm not even going to try and unseize this because I have my new ones, wherever they are. In this box. Ooh, unboxing video, look. Everybody loves an unboxing video. If I can even get into the box. Ooh. Everybody loves a shiny thing, especially when it's going on a Land Rover or a car. There you go. So, as you can see, those are meant to go in and out, whereas the ones on the other ones, there was no hope of those going in and out. So these are all from Brit Part, supplied by Devon 4x4, who I get most of my parts from. That red stuff is Loctite. that'll hold it all in when it's all tight, because obviously you don't want to fall them out. Right, anyway, got ahead of myself there. Next thing, take the disc off, which is that little screw there. And do that. If you're lucky, it will come undone with just a screwdriver. Or one of them. Well, you put that in, whack that end, and as you hit it, it turns it as well. So we need to take that off because we're going to put on this one out of its box. That's what a new brake pad should look like. That red stuff is a abrasive coating for bedding the brakes in when you first put them on. Now, put you down there a minute. Putting these on. Oopsie. Dimpled and grooved brake discs for better stopping performance, or so I've been told. So that's going in. And then obviously the other brake pads.
Oh dearie me, I'm ever so tired.
There's one, there's two, and these are from EBC Brakes. There's the part number if you're interested. If it'll focus, the yellow stuff. They do come in different colours, not just because they look pretty, they've actually got different performance levels on them depending on the colours. So yellow stuff is, I think it's a better all-round brake disc. You've got red stuff, which is works better in high heat. Green stuff, which is, I haven't got a clue what they are, but these are good all-rounders because obviously I'm not racing. I need it to work well from cold. But yeah, so I'll get that disc off, and then we'll go from there. Contrary to popular belief, sometimes the bit that actually goes in the screw hole doesn't actually fit. So that's a Phillips head, and I obviously used a flat head because it had sheared it off. Well, it didn't shear it off, it rounded it off rather. So this, but it worked, that's the main thing. Get this little screw out. Little screw there. The annoying thing is the new disc doesn't come with them, so I should put that back in, but very loosely, with a lot of copper slip. So right, now we got the joy of getting the brake disc off. This, it comes off and separately from the studs and the hub. That's where the wheel bearing would go, is in there. But yeah, that, I'll have to beat on that for a while. I'll see if I can do it one-handed. It's going to be very loud. I can put you over here. Leave you lot here on my makeshift YouTubing stand thing. I do need to get a GoPro and all that, but I haven't come across one that I like yet, so you'll just have to bear with. That'll do, right?
There we go.
Oh, it's a proper workout doing this. Done out this middle of August, it's boiling hot as well. Oh, pardon me. Right, that's the hub. That's the disc off. What we'll do now is put some copper slip around that and the inside of here. And then put that one back on. So yeah, I don't know if you need to see me do that, but I suppose you can if you like, but I don't know. Put you back here again.
I've made a bit of a boo-boo.
I was looking for the copper grease then.
But you lot are being propped up by the copper grease.
How inconsiderate of you. Fine. You really should wear gloves doing this, but I'm a farmer, so I'm exempt. I have got some sort of qualification in doing mechanics, so if you see me anything doing dodgily, if you see me doing anything dodgy, just remember, I'm doing it professionally. So if I cut my leg off, jacking it up, I've cut my leg off professionally. Make sure you always remember that. Not that I want to cut my leg off. That would be ridiculous. All this copper grease does is just makes it a bit easier to get it all apart when it's somebody else's turn to get it apart. Which I'm sure I'll wear these out in my lifetime. Well, I hope so. Mind you, seeing as I've done the brakes, it depends if they work. So obviously the studs will line back up. Where is it? Like so. So that goes back on the hub. Like that. Much easier. Put a bit of copper grease on the stud. Put that in where it goes. That'll just help it seat better. But this doesn't hold the disc on as such. It's more, because obviously the wheel sits on there, so the wheel holds it on. This is just there to, I don't really know why that's there. It's just there to be another irritating thing that you have to, another irritating thing you have to contend with when taking a wheel and disc apart. This is the correct way to put a grooved brake on, because you spend most of your life the wheels going that way. The dust will collect in there, and obviously if this was facing that way, it'd collect all the dust at that end, whereas it'll get rid of it like that and it disperses the heat better. That's the idea of a vented brake anyway. Right, on to the next bit, which will be put the caliper carrier back on, which I can put you back in there. Yeah, I'll do that in a minute. That's better. I went to put you lot in here and I took a photo of myself. Is that right? Can you see that? Does that help? Right. Remember these bolts we took out? I'm going to put a little bit of copper slip on those. Just so they will actually come out again one time. It's one time at band camp. Drop in the comments below if you know what I'm on about. With this one time at band camp. What film that's from.
do still have a bit of Loctite on them. But I think it is a bit silly that they don't come with new ones, to be honest, because this bit does. I'll take those out so I catch my knuckles on those, because that really hurts. No, that's undoing it. Put you back and still doing ratcheting. I mean, I could have at least done this bit and then brought it back. Click! That's that torqued. Click! Yep. That's them. Next bit. What's the next bit? Caliper. So. If you can see this, I have to clamp this pipe to stop all the brake fluid running out of it, and then that will be put the pads in on this, put that on, then we should be done. And then we'll have to bleed the brakes. Bleeding the brakes is just getting any air bubbles out of the, because I don't know whether it's out of the system, I don't know what brake fluid is, whether it's a hydraulic or some kind of, it's a fluid. It's a fluid that breaks. Therefore, it's called brake fluid. It's highly corrosive. Which is weird. Why have something corrosive in a braking system? But you know, we, as the public, aren't meant to ask questions. Right, so I have undone this banjo nut. I've loosened it off with the gun, which is inappropriate, but it works. Undo that, remove the brake caliper, and do not lose those little banjo washers. Should probably put new ones in, but I don't have any. These weren't leaking anyway. But if you don't put those in, it will leak everywhere. Here we have the new shiny cap. I might put some footage in from when I did before, but that kept going wrong, and it's just a nightmare not having a proper camera or anything to do any of this with. But I will get one eventually. I'm looking into it because I would like to be able to shoot better videos than I do. And have a tripod and all the things, as my sister would say, all the pretty things. Oh, her website's gone live actually for Billy Bandanas. I don't know what the website name is, but it's for leads and like dog stuff. Well, including the name. Billy Bandanas, she makes leads and all sorts of stuff like that. So go check that one out if you're into that sort of thing. Which I can't imagine many of you watching are.
because you'll be
into cars. Where the hell's that gone?
Where do I put my Allen key? Tell me. Tell me, please. Because...
Oh, there's my knife.
I'm actually lost as to where I put that. Oh, God. Hang on. Right, I found it. It was in the straw. Well, hey. It was on the floor, buried, so I couldn't see it. You'd have thought, seeing as I got a perfectly decent workshop next door, I'd go in there and do this, but no, I like to punish myself by doing it the difficult way. No, brake pads. Brake pad. What you want to do is smear a bit of copper grease either side where the pad touches the caliper, and then a little bit where they slide as well. So it stops them squeaking, apparently. Put those in like that. Obviously, pink side facing the disc. Yeah, I mean, try not to get any on the disc. I don't think it'll be the end of the world if you do, but you know, I'm not an expert. If you don't want to listen to me, you don't have to. I'm just here for fun, really. I'm sure many YouTubers are. You know, instead of talking to myself, I'm talking to you lot. So I seem a bit less clinically insane. I'm not. But I do talk to myself a lot. But then who doesn't? If you didn't talk to yourself, you'd go mad. I would. That's the reason I started doing this. Somebody else might want to see me doing this. But yeah, caliper on there. Do these box up with the red lock tight on. Oh, you sod. The trick is to try and get them on. Without having to use a spanner to hold the... stop them spinning in there. Ow! Yes, I did just punch myself in the face. Right. Agri bodge time. Ha! Ha ha! I win. There. They should all be tight. Ugh. And that. Come here. That is how you do that. I wouldn't worry about getting oil on this part. It's the outer part that does the braking. But yeah, new caliper carrier, new pads. And a new disc. All that's left to do is bleed it. I will have to have my brother-in-law's help, and I don't know whether he'll want to be on camera. But you put a little hose on this. Little bleed nipple there. Put a little hose on that. Undo it. Get in. Pump it. Pump the brakes.
and the brake fluid will come out of there with a load of air, and that is how you do that. And then with two people, you know, it's a lot easier with two people. You'd have one person sat in there doing the brakes while another one was out here doing this. But I'll see if he'll be on camera doing it. No harm in asking. What are you doing, Benjamin?
Bleeding the brakes.
Would you like to go and pump the pedal?
I shall.
Fluid.
I have put some in, yes. So he has just gone to test them because he knows what it's on about, but the trouble is he drives cars that aren't Land Rovers, so his brakes will work, whereas Land Rover ones are just crap. Marvellous. Right, that's that done. I'll probably have to do the fronts at some point, but they're not worn out yet, so. Yeah, that's the pile of bits you're left with. Nice little bit for the scrap man. Yeah. Discovery D2 rear disc brake caliper carrier pad and all of that. Yeah, job done. Thank you ever so much for watching. Do comment, like and subscribe because it'll help me make better videos. Yeah, I shall see you in the next one.
Has that made the situation any better? Blinding me. Can you see that? Oh, turn it around and put
it. Turn it around and put the flash on.
Can you see anything? Torch test. Fucking hole there.